a long way away from Glasgow.
What you got happening here is our nation earning money.
Coal is here to stay.
But there's nothing to replace that. We haven't got a replacement to maintain your standard of living if that is lost.
The United Kingdom's Prime Minister wouldn't agree.
Glasgow has sounded the death knell for coal power. It's a fantastic achievement.
Countries committing at the climate summit to phase down coal, but not phase it out.
Prime Minister, do you agree that COP26 sounded the death knell on coal?
No.
So you disagree with Boris?
No, I don't believe it did. And for all of those who are working in that industry in Australia, they'll continue to be working in that industry for decades to come.
It's a big green light for us to build more coal mines, supply the world more coal, because that is what brings millions of people out of poverty.
Despite signing on to the COP26 final pledge, Australia is not only leaning further into coal, but also refuses to strengthen its 2030 target.
What matters is what you actually achieve. And so we're well above our target.
As for the opposition, Anthony Albanese won't be playing his climate card until the end of the year.
I don't want to spoil the announcement.
For the second week in a row, the Prime Minister is on a marginal seat list, starting his week here in Western Sydney, where the Coalition holds the federal seat of Lindsay by a 5% margin. But the Prime Minister isn't taking any chances. He wants to shore up as much support as possible during this unofficial election campaign.
Small and medium-sized businesses are at the heart of our economic recovery.
The latest news poll saw the Coalition claw back some ground, gaining 2 points on the primary vote and 1 point two-party preferred, still trailing behind Labor, but Scott Morrison is more than happy to be seen as the underdog.
Well, I think that's fairly clear, but I've been there before.
Stella Todorovic for 10 News First.